doing? You keep changing decisions. Okay, I'll get you some water.
September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Sweep that floor, kid. Oh, I started life as an orphan, a child of the street, here on Skid Row. He took me and gave me shelter, a bed, most of friends from treated me like dirt, mostly a swamp, which I am. So I live
downtown.
What's your home address? You live
downtown.
When your life's a mess, you live
downtown.
When depression's just status quo. I constantly pray I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot or I'll rot here.
Downtown,
tell me how and I will I'll get out of here.
Downtown,
I start climbing up here to get out of here. Exotic cuttings.
Snip, daddy.
Because he knows, you see, strange plants are my hobby.
Daddy.
He didn't have anything unusual there that day.
Nope, daddy.
And I was about to, you know, walk on by.
Good for you.
When suddenly, and without warning, there was this total eclipse of the sun. It got very dark, and there was a strange humming sound like something from another world.
Daddy.
And when the lights came back, this weird plant was just sitting there.
Oopsie-doo.
It just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias.
Ah, 3-2.
Now, I could have sworn it wasn't there before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway.
Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
For $1.95.
Daddy, watch out, Daddy.
My hand and in a snap, something out of Edgar Allan Poe has happened.
Zap, don't it go to show you never know. One day you're slinging cash, feeling so rejected, lightning flash. You get resurrected, make a splash. Now you're in the promise. Santa's on, Santa's on, Santa's on.
shouldn't worry one more minute about that creep. There's a lot of guys who would give anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
I don't deserve
that creep, Oren Scrivello.
I deserve the creep like Oren Scrivello, DDS. Do you know where I met him? The gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. I used to work there on my nights off and we weren't making much money. And I'd put on cheap and tasteless outfits, not nice ones like this. And I'd roll around in low and nasty apparel.
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You're a nice girl, and I always knew you were. Underneath all the bruises and handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex. Standing beside you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your
nobody
friend.
Ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early and mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers and me, I'd say, sure. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside me. He don't give me orders. He don't condescend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide me with sweet understanding. Seymour's my friend.
Tell me this feeling lasts till forever. Tell me the bad times are clean washed away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening for losers like I've been. It's so hard to say. Suddenly see.
Hey, little lady, hello.
Who is that?
You're looking cute, asking me.
Who's here, Seymour?
You're looking mighty sweet. No, it ain't Seymour, it's me.
Oh, my God.
Your friendly Audrey, too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe this.
Believe it, baby, and talk.
Am I dreaming?
No, and you ain't in Kansas neither.
What?
Oh, relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you, sweetheart?
A favor?
I need me some water in the worst way. Look at my branch. I'm a goner, honey.
I don't think
Come on and give me a drink.
No, it's not happening.
Hey, little lady, be nice.
Are you sure it's, you just want
to
water?
Sure do, I'll drink it straight. Don't need no glass and no eye.
Branches are gonna dry you.
Don't need no twist of a lime. And now it's supper time. Relax.
Oh my God,
it'll be easier.
Help me.
Join your desperate friend in motion. Get right inside.
Get off of her. Get off of her. Get off of her. Get. Audrey, please. Are you all right?
Yes. No.
Audrey. Audrey, please. Please don't die. Please, I need you.
You know, the plant just said the strangest thing to me. He said that Orin and Mr. Mushnik were already inside.
It's true. I fed them to it.
Is that what made it so big and strong and you so famous?
I've done horrible things, Audrey. But not to you. Never to you.
But I want you to, Seema.
What?
When I die, which will be very shortly, I want you to put me inside of the plant.
Audrey, you don't know what you're talking about.
But I do. You see, if I get eaten by the plant, then I become part of it, and that way we'll always be together, and that's the last gift I can give you. You wash my tender leaves. You smell my sweet perfume. You water me and care for me and see me bud and bloom. I'm feeling strangely happy now, contented and serene. Oh, don't you see? Finally, I'll be somewhere that's green.
Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly, Seymour is standing beside you. Don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly, Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your
nobody ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early, Mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers, me, I'd say sure. Suddenly, Seymour is standing beside me. He don't give me.
still forever. Tell me the bad times.